So hi guys, it's Precious Bria. Welcome to my channel or welcome back. Today I'm going to be showing you how to get this soft glam look. First, we're going to make sure to start off with a good primer. Primer is going to help with the longevity of your makeup. And so I think this step personally is very important. And depending on what type of primer you get, this primer is a blurring primer. It's also gonna help you get more of a smooth and flawless finish. Next, we're going to move into foundation. If you're looking for more of a flawless finish, then I would definitely say that you should go in with a beauty blender. If you want more of a full coverage type of look, then I would definitely say that you should go in with a brush. This also depends on which type of foundation you're using. I typically go medium to full coverage, but they also have lighter foundations and skin tints that you can use, which is going to give you more of a skin-like or natural finish. But still, I think either way, if you want more of a natural and flawless finish, in my personal opinion, I think you should go in with a beauty blender. If you want more of a full glam, full coverage type of look, then definitely go in with a makeup brush. And next we're gonna move on to concealer. I would suggest that if you want more of a natural look, then you don't have to go up as many shades as I do. I like more of a snatch look, which is why my concealer is so light. Same as the foundation, I suggest that if you want more of a flawless natural finish, then definitely do the beauty blender. If not, then go in with the beauty brush. Take your time when blending out the foundation and blending out the concealer. Take your time. If you take your time, I promise you, your makeup is gonna come out looking so much better. I've been doing essentially this same look for forever, so I can do it pretty quickly, but even still, the days that I'm just like super relaxed and just taking my time to do it, it just comes out so much better. So that's another key tip. So now I'm going to just spot correct. I do have hyperpigmentation around my mouth, and so I like to get a little bit extra coverage. A trick that I like to do is to leave my concealer on there. That gives me the opportunity to allow the concealer to thicken up a little bit. And then while I'm waiting for that to dry down a little, I'm gonna move on to my cream contour. I also always blend out my cream contour with a beauty blender. So now we're just going to go in with the setting powder. This is just the Huda Beauty Loose Setting Powder. This is a holy grail. I love this product. I definitely think that everyone should invest in a high quality setting powder. This definitely needs to be in your makeup kit immediately. This is worth it 100%. This does a great job at just blurring out and just giving you a really flawless finish. You're definitely going to be looking like a filter in real life with this. And then next, we're going to just go in with a powder contour. This is the Rihanna Fenty. This is the foundation powder. And I love this. This just brings so much warmth back into my face. It's so, so, so pretty. And it does a good job at, you know, contouring, but it also is like a contour, in my opinion, slash bronzer. If you're looking for more of a warmth look, I would go in with a bronzer. But if you're just concerned about, you know, contouring, then definitely just get either like a foundation powder or a contour palette. For my eyeshadow, when I'm trying to be like super basic, I definitely just go in with what I'm already using, which is the contour powder that I'm using. And then on my eyelids, I typically go in with the highlight color that I use on my under eye area. And it makes it look like I have on eyeshadow when I don't, technically. So it gives me a glam look while being able to repurpose some of the products that I use on other areas of my face, which I love. I recently became a blush girl, so we're definitely gonna pack that blush onto there. I think that if you get a blush that complements your skin tone, blush just really helps complete the look. It gives it a lot more warmth to the look, and it's just like a fun and playful, you know, thing to add in. For my brows, I'm going to be going in with the pomade. What I will say about a brow pomade is that it's going to give you more of a defined brow. If you want something a little bit more natural, then I would go in with the brow powder or a brow. Just take your time and try to get the shape that you want. If you can't get it exactly how you like it, no worries. You can just go in and clean it up with some concealer, and then you can get the shape that you're looking for. And for concealer, I like to use the same one that I spot correct with. So it's going to be a concealer that matches my skin tone. I find that this helps me to get a defined eyebrow look without giving me like that weird halo effect. And then I'm going to be going in with some highlight. I still love highlight. And then next, some mascara, just enough so that it would be able to blend in with my lash. And of course, I'm going to be adding my lashes. My favorite type of lashes are always going to be more of a natural wispy look. I think that those are so pretty. And an extra step that I like to take is to put some eyeshadow or some type of product. This is actually the blush that I used on my lower lash line. I feel like this just helps give the look an extra pop. And it also helps to define your eye shape as well. And so I really like taking that little extra step. And of course, for lips, I'm always gonna line my lips with a brown liner, and then I'm just gonna go in with a gloss. Sometimes I do go on with a lipstick and then a gloss, but typically I just go in with the gloss. And we always have to make sure that we spray our face with a setting spray, because this is what's going to help everything melt together and help with the longevity of the makeup look. And now the look is complete. So this is the finished look. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. And I hope to see you guys in another video. Don't think it'll help if there's a ring with a lot. Where I'm from, it's certain soda.